Hello and welcome along. Today on Rockwood, we are going to be using our hired machines to cut some more wood down and hopefully raise some more money so that we can either hire them for longer or start to buy some machines. So without further ado, we will get out of our little styre that we do own and head over to the Scorpion. So we have an hour and 18 minutes left on the hire of this, but we are running at real time, so that should be fine. So we will turn on the harvesting head and we're going to try and get, zoom out a bit, we've got a couple of really big trees up the back here, so we're going to try and do those. We have a cutting length of 1 meter, so we're going to up that to 6, which should do our trailer. So this is a fairly small tree, so we'll leave that for now. This one is much bigger. Go. So we will then go, and load that onto the trailer. Into this. And into our big one. Almost already. Right, so we've cut these at 6 because 6 should fit in here, but it's tight. Go. Well, that hasn't quite worked as hoped. It's a bit like trying to use a sledgehammer to whack in a nail. This is a little bit of overkill for this job. There we go. Right. Pull that out. There we go. There we are. No! Oh, we're back in exactly the same position. We might need to use something with a little bit more finesse than that. So we'll just jump out of this and grab this. Wow. Cool. That kind of answers that, really. So, back into our scorpion, and we get another tall tree, and see if we can do a little better with that one. Oh, got stuck in the stump now. I've heard a few people say that for forestry in this game, using two joysticks is the way to go. And I can see why. It's not the easiest thing to control with a mouse and a keyboard. And I know I've said this before on my other maps that I've played. Is that yes, there is. Being able to play it with the mouse and keyboard gives me a certain sense of satisfaction, but it's not the easiest way to play this game. Right. Okay. So, we mark out that. See if we can control it a bit better this time. Right. So, on we go. Right. I think cutting them 5 would help, simply because at the moment so we're going to put these ones into here. And because we haven't managed chips out of those. And then the next tree we're going to cut at 5 meter length, because we can easily fit that on the trailer. I would love to put 6 meter ones on there, but I don't think that's possible. Right, so we need to chip these. So. Turn that on. There we go. How full is that? 81%, so that's not going to take much more. So, we'll take out... I think we'll take out the short one. Here. And then that will do us for our wood chips this episode. Over here, and we'll use the smaller one for this. But interestingly, we would seem to do something with something better that has an extending arm to put into here. This also, though, isn't the eventual wood chipper I want. No, actually, to be honest, nice chunk of tree. We will load this up. Because we're using this and can be a little more accurate. Yeah. This may actually finish this off as well. We put these two on here. Should be good. Ideally, we want to have a bigger trailer for doing this. In there now. So what we'll do now is we will chip these two bits. We've got some time on our lentils still. Okay. So, see how much this gives us. Ooh. We do need to get the stump grinder up here. No, that doesn't have enough weight to get in that. So, let's go. I can't go over the stump. There we go, that's got in that. Okay. taking it over. Right. Ooh, this is not good. Load this up with the style. It's out of line now. Nine. So probably a couple more. It's pretty close. And the question is, can we pick two apple pies with this little tractor? Oh, it's not happy about it. Very much not happy about it. Ah, oh, just managed to get it in. There we go, that's full. That's ready. And just these three to load on. So. The last one from the other side. And then I think that will put us in a good position to sell them off as our last part of today's episode. So this is quite a heavy one. The one on the other side does not look overly stable. And this one definitely isn't as I put it on the top. So no. Right. I think the Libra is great for if I was doing a large trailer and large logs. For more specific work that I'm trying to do at the moment, it's not a hugely useful piece of equipment. Not while I'm using smaller stuff. Right, that is massively not in the right place. Let's see if we, I'm very wary about trying to push this log back on this side. But it is not sitting, definitely not sitting in the right place. Ooh. For that one needs to be sitting not to me in there like that. There we go. Right, so we'll try and leave this trailer over to here. Go right. Pull that down. Let's go sell this. So a nice full thing of wood chips and a nice full stack of logs. I think that was a little bit more successful than we previously had. Remains to be seen whether we can actually unload it with as much success, but we'll give it a go. First, we are going to... up. As always. So. Massage them out. There we go. There we are. So. That was a very nice amount of money off that. That is awesome. Right, and then this, the tip side, is currently set to back. So we want it set to right. There we are. So that we can just... pull in round here like this. And tip out our wood chips. And a nice full trailer of wood chips is worth a good amount of money as well, which is brilliant. So we can look at now. So that was excellent. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. It's been a little more successful than some of our forestry on Friday. If you have enjoyed it, please leave a comment, give us a like and share it. And for all the latest videos from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.